Hello students, in last session the question number 14 from the exercise 6.3 is completed. Now we discuss next 15 number from the exercise 6.3. See the question in your textbook on page number 141. A vertical pole of length 6 meter cast a shadow 4 meter long on the ground, and at the same time a tower cast a shadow 28 meter long. Find the height of tower. The two things are given, one is pole and another is tower. We have to draw one pole AB, represent pole, and BC is the shadow of a pole. AB is vertical to the ground, AB perpendicular to BC. We need to join A to C. AB is a pole. The vertical pole of length 6 meter, AB 6 meter. Cast a shadow 4 meter long. BC is the shadow of pole 4 meter. At the same time, tower cast a shadow 28 meter long. Suppose PQ represent the tower and QR is the shadow of tower 28 meter long. Both triangles are right triangles. First of all, write AB. AB is equals to height of pole is equals to 6 meter. BC is equals to length of shadow of pole is equals to 4 meter. PQ is equals to height of pole. We need to find it so that the question mark. Next, QR is equals to length of shadow of tower, here is a tower, not a pole. Height of tower is question mark. Length of shadow of tower is equals to given 28 meter. Here the triangle ABC and triangle PQR are the right triangles, so that in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, first of all, the angle ABC is equals to angle PQR. Both are 90 degree because the pole and the tower are vertical to the ground. Pole and tower are vertical to the ground. Next, take any one angle. Angle P is equals to angle A, otherwise angle C is equals to angle R. Angle C means ACB is equals to angle PRQ because of angle of elevation of sun. At the same time, rays of sun passes through the top of pole and the top of tower. That's why the angle C is equal to angle R. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle B and Q are corresponding, so that take Q in middle, C and R, C at last, then R at last. Remaining vertex is P, so that the triangle PQR, because of angle similarity criterion, therefore the ratio of the corresponding sides are equal, AB upon PQ is equals to BC upon QR, where AB is equals to 6, PQ remains as it is, BC is 4 and QR is equals to 28. 28 and 4 cut is possible, 4 sevens are, by making PQ as a subject, PQ is equals to 7 into 6, that's why PQ is equals to 42. But what is PQ? PQ is the height of tower, therefore height of tower is 42 meter. Hence the question number 15 is completed. Now we discuss last question number 16 from exercise 6.3. Question number 16. See the question in a textbook on a page number 141. If AD and PM are medians of triangle ABC and triangle PQR respectively, where triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR, prove that AB upon PQ is equals to AD upon PM. First of all, the two triangles are given, one is ABC and another is PQR. We have to draw two triangles ABC and another triangle is PQR. AD and PM are medians. AD, that's why BD and DC are equal. And the next median is PM. QM is equals to MR. First of all, write the given things. Here, AD and PM are medians of triangle ABC and triangle PQR respectively. Again, one thing is given, triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. If two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles are equal and the ratio of the corresponding sides are also equal. Therefore, AB upon PQ is equals to BC upon QR is equals to AC upon PR. It is our result number 2 is also given. We need to prove that AB upon PQ is equals to AD upon PM. Here AB upon PQ and AD upon PM comes in triangle ABD and in triangle PQM. We have to use the given thing. Given thing is that triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. So that the first of all, take from one, AB upon PQ is equals to BC upon QR. AB upon PQ remains as it is. Now replace BC with 2BD and QR with 2QM, because AD and PM are medians. That's why AB upon PQ 2 cut, and we get BD upon QM. BD upon QM, and the angle ABC, it is our result number 2. And angle ABC is equals to angle PQM because of triangle PQR, because of triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. That's why if angle ABC is equals to angle PQR, then angle ABD is equals to angle PQM. It is our result number 3. Now we have to use result number 2 and result number 3. Take the triangles. In triangle ABD and triangle PQM, from 2, AB upon PQ is equals to BD upon QM. It is from 2, and angle ABD is equals to angle PQM. It is from 3. Therefore, the triangle ABD similar to B with Q, Q. ABPQ, here is the PQ and the R, or sorry, not R, but it is M, QM with BD, QM with BD, because of side angle side similarity criterion. Now take the ratio which required in proof: AB upon PQ. AB upon PQ is equals to AD upon PM. AD upon PM. Sides are proportion. Hence proved. AB upon PQ is equals to AD upon PM is proved. If two triangles are similar, then their medians are proportional to the ratio of their corresponding side. Here, the exercise 6.3 from our textbook is completed. Now we discuss areas of similar triangle in which the theorem 6.6, the proof is not required. Now we see the new point areas of similar triangles. The theorem 6.6 is given. The proof of theorem 6.6 is not in our syllabus, is cut out from our syllabus, but the statement is important through solving a sum. The statement is given that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. If triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, then what the statement says? The ratio of the areas of two similar triangles. Triangles are similar, then ABC upon PQR, ratio of the areas of two triangles, is equals to the square of the ratios of their corresponding side. AB corresponds to PQ, but square of the ratio of their corresponding side. Second is BC upon QR whole square, and next is AC upon PR whole square. It is used to solve a sum. Now we discussed example number 9. From a textbook on a page number 143. See the question first. Whenever you see your e-learning session, open your textbook first. In figure 6.43, one figure is given. The line segment XY is parallel to side AC of triangle ABC, and it divides the triangle into two parts of equal areas. Find the ratio AX upon AB. First of all, draw figure given in textbook. Triangle ABC, XY is parallel to AC. Here, line segment XY parallel to AC of triangle ABC, and it divides, means XY divides triangle ABC into two parts of equal areas. Means what? Area of BXY, that's Y. Area of BXY, you can also write like this. BXY is equals to AXYC. It is a given. Area of ABC is equals to BXY plus AXYC. It is a result number 1. Now we replace AXYC with BXY. ABC is equals to BXY plus BXY. ABC is equals to 2BXY. We need to find AX upon AB. Here, take the ratio BXY upon ABC is equals to 1 upon 2. It is our result number 2. Now, from the figure in triangle ABC, XY is similar to AC. Parallel to AC, not similar. In triangle, take two triangle BXY and the triangle ABC. Both triangles are similar triangles. One angle is common, XBY. Angle XBY is equals to angle ABC because both are common angles. And the next is, take any one angle. They are corresponding angle XYB. Angle XYB is equals to angle ACB. Reason is corresponding angles. Therefore, the triangle BXY is similar to B with B, the first is B, Y with C at last, which is BAC, because of angle similarity criterion. If the two triangles are similar, then according to theorem 6.6, the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equals to the square of the ratios of their corresponding side. That's why area of BXY upon area of BAC means ABC is equals to ratio of their corresponding side, square of the ratio. We need to find the ratio AX upon AB. AB is here but AX is not here. Corresponding side is BX. So that BX upon BA means AB whole square. But from 2, BX upon BXY upon ABC is 1 upon 2 is equals to BX upon AB whole square. On removing a square, we have to take a square root. That's why BX upon AB is equals to 1 upon root 2, because 1 upon 2 is equals to BX upon AB whole square. That's why BX upon AB is equals to 1 upon root 2. That's why BX is equals to K and AB is equals to root 2K. From the figure, AB is the addition of AX and BX. AB is equals to AX plus BX, where AB is equals to root 2K, AX as it is, and BX is equals to K. Now making AX as a subject, AX is equals to root K minus K. K is common, into bracket, root 2 minus 1. AX. The value of AX is here, K into bracket, root 2 minus 1. Now we have to take ratio that we need to find out, which is AX upon AB. AX upon AB, where AX is a K into bracket, root 2 minus 1. Upon AB, AB is equals to root 2K. Root 2K. Now KK cut, remaining root 2 minus 1 upon root 2. Now first of all, make the denominator rational. By rationalizing the denominator, multiply with root 2 and divide with root 2. Root 2 multiply with root 2, get 2 minus root 2 upon 2. It is the ratio AX upon AB. 2 minus root 2 upon 2, which is required ratio. Hence the example number 9 is completed here. Whenever we meet in next session, we discuss our exercise 6.4. The exercise 6.4 is depends on a theorem 6.6. Keep in mind, the proof of theorem 6.6 is not in our syllabus, but keep in mind the statement of theorem 6.6 and how to write symbolic form of theorem 6.6. Now, whenever we meet in next session, we discuss our exercise 6.4.